I have screwed up Kish 5 times in a row. And I don't mean at some point in my life when I was learning to cook. I mean now. I mean after I made that Kish video showing you how well it can work. Yes, for 5 times in a row, my custard leaked right through the bottom of my crust. And it happened to one of my viewers. Hi, Gordon. Thank you so much for your feedback. So, given my problems and Gordon's problems, I was determined to get to the bottom of this. Turned out that the solution to this mystery was right there in the original footage, but not for the quiche, for Stella Park's pie dough. You know, in the media, nobody ever shows you the whole story because the whole story is messy and complicated and boring and long. But in some cases, the whole story can be very enlightening. So here's what actually happened that day. I made a batch of Stella's dough, rolled out half of it, and started looking for a pan that would produce the most click-worthy quiche. I wanted a quiche that was impressively tall, but since I didn't have a deep quiche pan, I decided to improvise with a cake pan. I fitted the dough into the pan, covered with plastic, and put it in the fridge overnight. The next morning, I lined it with foil and weights and baked it. Then I tugged and I tugged at the foil, but no matter how gentle I was trying to be, I couldn't pull it out without breaking the dough. Well, I thought, that'll teach you who uses a cake pan for a quiche. Luckily, I still had the second half of the dough still in my fridge. I rolled it out, put it into a tart pan, and chilled in the fridge for 20 minutes. I didn't bother covering it with plastic, since drying out wasn't an issue for such a short time. Of course, in the video, I didn't want to confuse you and give you Stella's instructions to cover with plastic and chill overnight. I was so worried about sticking after my cake pan disaster that I first lined the tart pan with parchment and then with foil. The foil came out so easily the second time that I didn't think parchment was worth mentioning. After all, Stella doesn't use it, so why should I? The quiche came out perfectly, and all was good, until a few weeks later, I made as the same exact quiche, and the custard leaked right through the bottom into a horrible puddle all over the baking dish. Well, to be fair, I did mess with the dough a tiny bit. I used the same measurements, but I was trying to come up with an easier way to smash the butter. So I smashed butter a little bit differently, and I thought, well, again, that'll teach you, don't mess with the dough. I remade the dough a few days later and tried again. This time the custard stayed in the tart pan, but the bottom crust was still soggy. So I tried one more time. This time I decided to line the bottom of the tart with parchment and then foil during the blind baking. Still soggy. I was at a loss and I decided to Google for how to solve the leaky quiche problem. The most helpful advice came from LA Times article by Russ Parsons. He was writing about Thomas Keller's quiche, and here are the tips that Keller gave us on how to avoid a leaky bottom. Roll the dough rather thick, 3/16 of an inch. Oops, mine was about half that thickness. Pour the custard into the hot crust as soon as the dough is pre-baked so that the bottom of the custard sets quickly. Cooks Illustrated had another great tip. Brush the crust with egg white as soon as it's out of the oven after blind baking to create a waterproof layer. All of this sounded great, and I decided to try it. Stella's batch of dough is a bit on the small side. Let's compare two recipes from Serious Eats. Kenji's uses 12.5 ounces of flour and 2.5 sticks of butter, and Stella's uses 8 ounces of flour and 2 sticks of butter. To make sure my dough would be thick enough, I used the entire batch of Stella's dough instead of half a batch I was using before. I rolled it to 3/16 of an inch. My circle ended up being about 16 inches in diameter. I fitted it into my tart pan, trimmed it, covered it with plastic and put it in the fridge overnight. The next day, I lined it with parchment and then foil, added the weight and baked it. Since the dough was thicker, it took longer to pre-bake and I waited patiently to make sure it was completely done, about 75 minutes at 350 Fahrenheit. I brushed it with egg white, as Cook's Illustrated suggested. Then I poured the custard into the hot crust. Kept my fingers crossed and put it in the oven. Let's see how we did. It seemed pretty solid, but the fact that it didn't slide right off the pan bottom was a bit worrisome. With the help of a spatula, I was able to slide it onto the board. Well, so this was definitely an improvement. Most of the bottom was nice and crunchy, but some parts of the crust were still slightly damp. That's probably why I felt a little bit of sticking when I was trying to get the tart out of the pan. There was no way around it. I had to face that nagging suspicion that chilling the dough in the fridge overnight covered with plastic was a problem. You see, when I got it out to bake in the morning, it was slightly damp. And even after it was done, it never felt completely set. It had like a little bit of a give to it, like it wasn't completely firm. I made another batch of dough and put it in the fridge uncovered for 2 hours instead of covered overnight. Did everything exactly the same, minus the veggies, because I ran out of them. In my earlier tests, I didn't want to waste the veggies and have baked many a boring quiche like this. I had the crust get plenty soggy with no veggies. The custards are so wet that a bit of spinach won't make or break it. Let's see how we did this time. Ah, that felt good. It finally worked. Not a single damp spot. I promise I checked every piece. So the biggest culprit was the condensation that happened under the plastic wrap as the tart dough sat in the fridge overnight. I'm embarrassed that it took me so long, but putting the dough covered with plastic in the fridge overnight was part of Stella's original instructions, and messing with baking recipes never works too well for me. So I was trying to keep the original recipe as intact as possible, especially that it worked just fine for galettes. But I'm guessing when you bake a galette, the dough is completely exposed, so much more evaporation happens in the oven. And when you're blind baking the crust for a quiche, the dough is completely covered with the pan underneath and with the foil inside, and so all that moisture has nowhere to go. Based on all this, here are my recommendations in order of their effectiveness. Do not cover the dough with plastic after rolling it out. How long can it sit in the fridge uncovered without drying out? Well, I have tested up to about 2 to 3 hours and it was absolutely fine. I don't know what would happen after 24 hours, but here's what I recommend you do. When you make the dough, shape it into a disc, wrap it with plastic and put it in the fridge overnight to give it a nice long rest. Yes, it's wrapped in plastic, but at this stage, it doesn't seem to be a problem at all. When you roll it out, put it back into the fridge to relax the gluten a little bit for 20 minutes to about 2-3 hours, and then bake. Roll the dough thicker. 3/16 of an inch or 4 millimeters is definitely safe. To tell you the truth, I actually preferred the texture of slightly thinner dough. Thomas Keller's quiche is insanely tall, a couple of inches. So there I can see why a 4 millimeter crust might be necessary. But if your quiche is on the thin side, like an inch or less, I think 3 millimeters would be perfectly fine. Line the dough with a round of parchment and then with foil to ensure no sticking. Brush the dough with a bit of beaten egg white as soon as it comes out of the oven. And finally, pour the custard in right away to help it set faster. If only YouTube would let us edit videos after publishing. You know, software people release patches for their software after it's out, right? I wish I could do the same, but unfortunately on YouTube that's not an option, so all I can do is make a corrections video. Thank you so much to Gordon for bringing this problem to my attention and helping me make the world a better place, one quiche at a time. This video was brought to you by viewers like you. If you liked it, click here to support my channel. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that little bell button for notifications so that you don't miss more videos of Helen screwing up baked goods. And if you're ever in the Boston area, maybe I'll see you in one of my classes.